right, we are here at the Funk Barbecue, and looks like you got yourself quite a, what is that, top it around?
You better believe it. This is Texas-style barbecue, baby. Not like they have in the North, baby. This is Texas, Texas, baby.
Well, I don't think they have anything quite like this in England, do they, Alfred?
Certainly not. Not for an afternoon picnic. We'd have tea and lemonade or something, but certainly, I don't know, some nice little crumpets with cheese and maybe a little...
Cheese?
Yeah, something like that.
Yes, well... Well, joining us, Hoss, come on in here. Hoss Funk coming in, and as you might suspect, via horseback. That's a nice-looking horse you got there. Real nice-looking. I beg your pardon?
This is Misty.
It's Misty. Yeah, I think Misty would like to have some of this barbecue sauce.
No, Misty doesn't drink barbecue sauce.
Doesn't drink barbecue
Misty
sauce,
is my favorite horse from the Double Cross Ranch, so...
Well, let me ask you, Jimmy Jack, do you have a horse on the Double Cross Ranch?
I got five horses.
Five horses, huh?
I got a horse for any day I want it.
Well, there are seven days in a week, but...
He doesn't have one for Saturday or Sunday, apparently.
Hey, I do, too! Oh, I got one for any day I want it!
All right, Jimmy Jack is... Look, you got to fix yourself a seven.
Yeah, I've already cut one. I've already cut a little slice of meat off here. Look at this. This is great. This is beautiful right here.
The Funks taught you how to do this. I understand that Terry Funk had something as far as the teaching of the finer skills of the barbecue. Is that correct?
You better believe it. You know, Texas born, Texas bred, baby. When we die, we'll be Texas dead. I'm telling you right now. But this is great. This is real down-home Texas barbecue, baby. Right, Hoss, baby?
Well, I wonder if you...
Woo, gosh,
you handling this is, talking about Texas is a little bit out of school, isn't it? You're any more of a Texan than I am.
Well, let me tell you what, we wanted to bring you a little Texas hat for you, some Texas chaps, and maybe a big old Texas horse for you to ride here. But you see, I'm not a big meat eater or anything. I'm a vegetarian, but I'm going to load this up because I want you to taste this.
What kind of, thank goodness you're not a Texan, because I don't know if there's any true Texan that's a vegetarian, right, Hoss?
No true Texan is a vegetarian. I'd like to say this reminds me of home, you know that? Everybody's sitting around a barbecue, everybody's having a good time, everybody's eating, but there is one thing that's missing from this barbecue, and that's my brother Terry Funk. My brother Terry Funk is the biggest party man in the state of Texas. Every week he sets up a barbecue just like that. He's not here. You know why he's not here? You know why he's not here?
Certainly know why he's not here.
Because of the junkyard dog. That's why he's not here.
Exactly, and... It seems to me that, will he return, by the way? I would assume that he did.
Yes, Terry Funk will be back.
We understand that the Jimmy Jack, if we can talk a little bit, is Jimmy Jack's exactly...
Well, Jimmy Jack is all right. Jimmy Jack is okay. Jimmy Jack is 26 years old, so he just hasn't said...
Why have we heard of Jimmy Jack Funk before? Why did you keep him away? It seems to me that... That report has it that this man is totally uncontrollable, even by the Funks.
Well, it's like I said, he's 26 years old. He's a great wrestler. He missed out on the 84 Olympics because of the boycott. Jimmy Jack is one of those good-looking young fellows. You see, we keep a mask on him. He's one of those people that all the women can't stay away from. And I can't keep Jimmy Jack away from all the women. That's why he's got the mask on. That's why we've kept him in the background.
Wait, what? How are you doing with this basting process over here?
It's looking great. Look at this. Look at this. You like a lot of sauce or what? Why the hell you like it, Vince? Come on, man.
Well, I've been known to get into the sauce from time to time, but I'm not too sure about this.
This is great.
I don't know.
How much time do we have left, guys?
How much time do we have left? How much time we have left for this barbecue? I think it's getting a little hot around here.
It's a great look at this. This looks great. It's well done, baby. Well done.
I'll tell you what. I'm going to go back and set up. I think our next guest is Bobby Heenan. Alfred, why don't you take over on the barbecue and wrap this sucker up? I'll catch you later.
Okay, Vince.
Tell him for us.
I'm not terribly well versed in these things, so perhaps, well, you wouldn't be either because you're not a Texan.
That's right, baby.
Maybe I should ask Horse about this.
Put this over here.
Well, this is...
Yeah, because we want you to try this. Look how good this sandwich is, man. This is a good old Texas sandwich, baby.
A little more sauce.
All right, I'll put a little bit more sauce on it right here.
No, thank you. Hey,
a little more sauce. Come here.
Get your hands off that.
He's hungry. He's hungry, Lord Alfred.
Just take your grubby hands off that
roof. Wait a minute. This is our barbecue. How can you come in our barbecue and tell us what to do? How do you like that, Lord Alfred? This is our barbecue. You come to our barbecue and you want to tell us what to do, Lord Alfred? You want to tell us what to do? Well, what you're seeing here, baby, is a sample of what we're going to do to the junkyard dog when we get our hands around him.
We might just take care of him for good like you, Lord Alfred. Huh? Where's your big buddy now, baby? Where's your big buddy now, Lord Alfred, huh? Look at him now. Look at him. You look good, Lord. You look good, Lord. You look good, baby. Make sure it's good and tight.
Okay, back with more TNT, and unfortunately, Lord Alfred Hayes has been detained, as we saw a few moments ago, and will not apparently be back with us for this show, and we will hopefully have you, hopefully he's all right. We'll have a little progress report on Alfred. You saw what happened to Lord Alfred Hayes. In any event, would you welcome our next guest, Bobby the Brain Heenan. All right, Mr. Heenan, did you see on the monitors what happened to Lord Alfred Hayes?
It was a shame.
It was a shame, wasn't it?
Yep, they should have hooked him up to that horse and drug him down the road. I wouldn't have left him on a tree. I'd have drug him around a little more. It's a shame they didn't.
You would have dragged him with...
with the horse. Or have him drag the horse, I don't care. I hear Lord Alfred Hayes is now 6'8". Wears a size 9 shirt. Neck.
I found nothing humorous at all about that last incident with the Funks. I find nothing humorous about your comments either in terms of Lord Alfred Hayes, who unfortunately has been suffered any number of attacks from individuals such as yourself here on TNT.
Now, you think the mess on him and that slop all over him the way he was, you think that's disgusting?
Yes, I do.
Well, then you know what it is like eating with Uncle Elmer and the boys.
Well, surely you have not dined with Uncle Elmer and the boys, but...